Alright, I've found a new game. And well, it's not really a new game, it's a game I already had for another system, but this is a really special version. It is the New Zealand Story. Yes, you may remember this game from an earlier review of mine from like 2017, where I compared the NES version and the Sega Master System version. But yeah, I went to the Bonami game convention in Apeldoorn and I found this game, and this is the Sega Mega Drive version. This is a Japanese game and it's quite rare. It had cost a pretty penny, but it's an absolutely fabulous version. So yeah, let's do just a playthrough of this version. Well, not really a playthrough, but more like a short review slash commentary. One thing I can say in advance is that this game is based on an arcade prototype. That makes it kind of special. It's different than the normal version of New Zealand Story that you might be familiar with. So, let's go! So, the noise you're hearing is from my Game Genie. It's like the default clicking sound. I have to use a Game Genie because it's a Japanese game. I might get into that a bit later. Also, the game is running on 60 Hz. So I'm also recording in that frequency, at least for the gameplay section. The actual camera you're seeing that I'm talking to is recording in 50 Hz. So yeah, that's a bit different. But here we've got the title screen, and yeah, it's just like the arcade. The only thing that is lacking, unfortunately, is the demo sequence. But it still has the really cute intro with Wally the Walrus. As you can see, the graphics are very nice. They're quite close to the arcade version. The Mega Drive is the perfect platform for this game, especially when it comes to the music, as the Sega Mega Drive sound chip was very similar to that of the arcade machine. And there we have Wally the Walrus chasing the kiwis. And yeah, this looks pretty much as good as the arcade version, and trust me, I can compare it with the Taito Legends version that I also have for the PlayStation 2, which is actually the arcade ROM. And yeah, that's a really good version as well, because that is the real thing. But yeah, this is just a port and it's an absolutely fabulous one. At first glance it looks very similar, but there are differences. This version is actually quite a bit harder. Especially those red spiky enemies, you've got to be pretty careful of those, they are nasty. I must also say that the shading on the little kiwi bird is really nice, graphically at least. Yeah, the enemies in this version are just a little bit tougher. And beware of those red spiky creatures. Because in this version, if you get touched by the enemy itself, you already die. And with some of the other enemies, you only die if you get touched by their weapon. And also there's more spiky ceilings, as you can see. But yeah, the reason this version is different is that before the game was originally released in the arcade, they made a prototype. And it was found that that version was just a bit too difficult, and they changed the game a little bit, and that was the version that got released. But after the like regular arcade release, they decided to release the prototype anyway. And this is nasty, I almost saved the little kiwi bird, but then those stupid demon bats got hold of me. Also, those ostriches are really fast. Oh, and that's another spiky creature that can really ruin your day. And this timing, the stopwatch is actually pretty nice, because it gives you some, just some leeway. And also the platform seems to be smaller. That's nasty. So let's get the balloon. Hey, okay. Oops. Hey, that was an interesting enemy that I have not seen in the other versions. I think we need to go here and then down like so. And there we've got a lever. Which should give you bonus points. And beware of the spikes. Ooh, that almost went wrong. Here's the water. I think we need to go here. Yeah, this is a catch-22. Well, I did it. But yeah, musically it's exactly like the arcade version, because the arcade machine uses a Yamaha YN2203 sound chip, which is the predecessor of the 2612. They belong to the same OPN family, if you're into FM synthesis chips. Did you know that the Rephase DX synthesizer that I have is also based kind of on the 4-operator FM family? Ooh, this looks very tricky, especially with those bloody spikes. Let's see, we've got some balloons here. Oh hey, that's nasty. Let's hope it does goes well this time. Let's go here. But yeah, this is basically the more hardcore version. Oops. My kiwi bird is still alive. Ah, the bloody balloon pops. Yeah, what should I do? Yeah, that's tricky. This is just a much harder version than the regular game. So, what should we do? Play another session? Another round? Yeah, let's do that. And we're actually back in the stage where we left off, so that's nice. Let's see if I can do it this time. Damn it! Ooh. Yippee, balloons. Ooh, the balloon almost burst. I don't think that's a good way to go. Let's get some oxygen first. We are now in an underwater maze. Oh dear. Uh-oh, my little kiwi is in need of some oxygen, unfortunately. Oh dear. Well, let's go straight there anyway. Oh, have I chosen the wrong path? I don't know. Let's get here quickly. So, let's give that little kiwi some air. And there's some more. Let's go up. I don't know if this was such a good idea. Apparently this is not the right path. So, yeah, we must be looking for a shorter path. It seems difficult to get through there. Let's get here. Let's fill this kiwi up with as much air as possible. So that seems to be plenty. There's another, like, ladder that you can get, but let's not do that. Oh, this is the wrong way. I took the wrong way. Let's go back here. Seems like the underwater sections are a lot longer in this version too. So they made it a lot harder. I think we have to go here. Yeah, that seems right. My air meter is filling up again. So my little kiwi bird isn't feeling so dizzy anymore. Oh, where do I go? I see a lot of like small platforms. Oh, that's nasty! The little kiwi bumped his head! Ah! Oh, why can't I get on that thing? Well, let's try it again. Oh dear. You know what? Let's go just another route entirely. Oh, come on! I must say I really like those elephant animals. They are really big and kind of cute looking. You can't make those jumps! Well, last try. Bloop, bloop. Got the right path the first time around. I don't think I should be going there. No, that's an impossible jump, unfortunately. So there you have it. That was a little play of the New Zealand story on the Mega Drive, the special arcade edition. So let's take a closer look at the packaging. This here is the box. As you can see, the artwork is quite different than the other versions. Yeah, I really like this one. It looks very nice and cute. And here's the back of it. And there's not much text. What there is all Japanese. I can't read it, but it looks really interesting, especially those screenshots. And here's the spine with this cute little kiwi bird over here. And then we've got the manual here, which is very nice and colorful. This is the front. And this is the back. So, the contents. Some more stuff. Yeah, booklet looks very nice as well. So how does it look on the Mega Drive? Well, it looks like this. That's the Japanese cartridge plopped on top of Game Genie, and it looks really different than your regular European Sega Mega Drive games. So that was it for the moment. I hope you enjoyed this short little play session of the New Zealand story on the Sega Mega Drive. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Ta-da! So let's take a look at this packaging. It's quite special and quite nice, I think, in design. This is the front of the box with our little kiwi bird, and just really nicely decorated. It really has a kind of Japanese feel to it. Even the spine is quite nice, because Mr. Kiwi is there, and here's the back of the box. This text is all in Japanese. I cannot read that, unfortunately. But yeah, it's kind of cute. Inside we've got the cartridge here. Japanese Mega Drive cartridges look a little bit different because they have this sticker going around here. and this is the back of it. Yeah, it just looks well, kind of different than your usual Western cartridges. And then we've got the booklet, and now those clips, like here, I like made specifically for this form factor. So manual looks nice and colorful. That's something you didn't really get with European games. They always had monochrome manuals and were not full color. So the Japanese manuals are really like something special in comparison. Well, everything is in Japanese, of course, but yeah, the design is just really like nice. And there's also subtle details, like here for instance is a kiwi. You've got a map of New Zealand in it. And the screenshots. Here are some of the things that you can use to float with. You've got the hot air balloon, the other balloons, this ostrich thing that actually goes really quick. Then we've got Tiki's weapons over here, like the bombs, the laser thing, the joystick. And here's all the fruits he can pick up, and here are the letters, and they say extend. If you collect all of them, you get an extra life. And here's all the enemies. And this is like that elephant looking thing that I mentioned. And those ones here are very annoying because they're very spiky. And these are those kind of possessed bats. And this is of course the killer whale, and there's Wally the walrus, and that's the back of the manual.